August 16, 2017, two rods and eight screws placed in my left leg. March 29, 2018, two rods and eight screws placed in my right leg. June 12, 2018, nerve release. March 22, 2019, hardware removal of all four rods and 16 screws.
I'm almost glad I got knocked down. Show me how to get back up from this here ground. I'm almost glad I was counted out.
Miserable malalignment.
Can you explain what exactly that is?
It's a condition where your femurs, they twist inward, and your tibias twist outward, and it puts a lot of pressure on your knees. When you run, your legs will swing outward. It's pretty rare. My surgeon didn't have many cases of it, and there's only a couple like surgeons in the city that deal with this type of thing.
So you've been dealing with this since birth. Can you talk a little bit about that?
I'm a quadruplet, so I have three twins. I was at the bottom, so I got smushed. My surgeon said it could be one of the causes, but then he said like genetic factors also rule into it.
When did it really start to affect you and you decided that something needed to be done?
I started to have really bad knee pain in eighth grade, my first year at IMG, when I started like training a lot. It definitely put a lot more like strain on my like knees, and also like the problem kept getting worse because I was growing.
Once you realized you met with your doctor and you discussed this, in that day, did he describe to you what kind of surgery you would have to go through?
So he took x-rays and stuff, and then he like brought me into your room and he like explained the stuff he could do like to fix it. He said I had to stop growing first, so I had to wait like 3 months.
So the first surgery happens in August. You have to get two rods and eight screws placing your left leg. What was that surgery like in the recovery?
It was really hard. I had to do PT. At first, I like didn't want to really do anything. I didn't really move off the couch for like 6 weeks. I was really sad that I can't play soccer for a while, and it was like really painful.
This is a very extreme surgery. This is breaking of the bones and placing rods into the bones.
It was definitely really hard, and I like struggled with it a lot. But I had so much support like along the way that helped me through it.
Was there something, was there a day, did you notice that your other leg was bothering you?
It was my first week back to like full contact training and stuff. And that was when I was like sprinting and like doing everything else that all my other teammates were doing. That's when I noticed like my knee was like starting to really hurt on my right leg. I went and saw my surgeon again, and he did like another evaluation.
You find out that you have to get surgery again on your right leg. Was it difficult finding that out?
I really just didn't want to go through it again because I had gone through all the recovery, and the recovery is really hard. But my mom, she made me get it, but like I'm glad she did because the pain is so much better now. If I waited longer, then like hips would tear and stuff.
So at this point now, you've got two major reconstructive surgeries. You've got about four rods, 16 screws, give or take. Well, that's not it, correct?
Nope.
You had to go through yet another surgery. What was that surgery?
It was a nerve reconstruction. When I had my left leg done, after the surgery, I had trouble like lifting up my toe. It wasn't like working properly. And then I had a lot of like numbness on the side of my leg. He said that probably from like when I got the surgery done, the nerve probably like was like compromised. He said he had to go back in and like loosen it. It was a lot of obstacles, but I just really loved playing soccer.
You had one final big one, correct?
Yeah.
That was all of the hardware removal.
Yeah.
Was that the most difficult one?
It was a little bit more difficult than my first one because it was both my legs at the same time. It was just really painful.
That recovery is you basically relearning how to walk, because that surgery is, people might not know this, but taking the rods out of your bone. I mean, what is that like?
It was definitely like hard to like get back after that one. I had to wait for the bone to like grow back inside where the rod was. And I couldn't get back to training because stress fractures were like on the table too.
What was it like getting back onto the soccer field for the first time?
Getting back on the field, I had to find like a new running form, and It was definitely a little awkward at first. My run, it looked a little funny. I adjusted and it was a lot better.
Through it all, what do you think was the most difficult part of it?
I'd say physical therapy. Strengthening and like just getting back and like pushing myself to be able to just get up and start like learning how to walk again and learning how to run and like use like my new legs like properly was really hard.
What have you learned about yourself?
I definitely know that I can overcome things now, and even though I got like so many obstacles thrown at me, I know I can overcome them now.
If you could give any advice to anyone that is going through a major surgery that takes them out of their sport for a little bit, what would you say to them?
Just make sure you go to physical therapy and just always know that things will get better and there's a light at the end of the tunnel. Get ready for me. The past 3 weeks, I've been feeling like an increase in pain in my foot. My foot doctor told me that our best bet right now would be to go get surgery. This isn't the end. The journey will continue. Hey, get ready for me. Hey, get ready for the comeback. Get ready for the comeback.